Today we are at Advanced Communication Lab at B.R. Siddhartha Engineering College, Vijayawada. In this lab, we are going to perform experiments related to microwave engineering, that is verification of expression, E-plane properties, H-plane properties, magic T properties, and also we are going to find out gain and directivity of a horn antenna, and also we are going to see how to measure impedance in a microwave bench. Today I have with me Mr. Chiranjeevi. He is working as a lab technician in this advanced communication lab.
So this is microwave bench setup. So this consisting of klystron oscillator. This is a klystron oscillator. So this is cooling fan, and this is isolator. Isolator is used for having zero reflected powers toward the source. And this one is variable attenuator, and this one is frequency meter, where we can measure frequency which we are working at this particular bench, and this one is slotted section, and this one is detector mount. In this particular bench, so we are having a klystron power supply. This power supply will be connected to reference klystron here, and then we are going to have a CRO for measuring the waveform of this particular bench, and on the other hand we are having a VSWR meter. So wherever we want to measure voltage standing wave ratio, so we can use this particular device, and also we can measure power. So we can find multiple options on this particular dashboard that we are going to discuss in detail later, but as of now mainly we are going to use a power supply, we are going to use a CRO, and we are going to use a VSWR meter. And this particular bench we are going to connect based on the experiment, and we are going to test our results on these particular equipment. This is isolator. This is very important component in microwaves. Whenever we are having a power coming from source towards this particular blocks, our intention is transferring the power or energy from this particular device, this particular component, to the this direction. Because of the impedance mismatching between the load and the source, there is a possibility of getting power back from load to the source. So that needs to be controlled, or that need has to be make it as zero, so that the source properties will not be affected. So in order to do that particular task, so we are having, and we are going to use a component called as isolator. So this isolator is going to have printed arrow mark on the top of the device. Here this arrow mark indicates the direction of power propagation. So that means only in this direction power is going to be traveled, and in the reverse direction it is going to absorb the entire reflected, and it is going to give you zero power reflections to the source. That is the properties of the isolator. So we are having some microwave components on this particular table. This is named as a E-plane T, where it is having three ports. Port 3, this is called as E-arm. This is port 1, this is port 2. Port 1 and port 2 are called as collinear arms. So these are rectangular waveguides. So we have total three ports, and this device or this component is named as E-plane T. And the next component is again a three port device. So where we are having three ports, and entire thing is a rectangular waveguide. So here this particular port is called as H arm, and these two are called as collinear arms. So this is E arm T, and this is called as H arm T. We are going to have a one more component named as magic T, which is a combination of E plane T and H plane T. So since it's a combination of E plane T and H plane T, so we are going to have total four ports. So port number 1, port number 2, port number 3, and port number 4. Total we are having four ports. Out of four ports, so these two are called as collinear ports or collinear arms, and this one is your E arm, and this one is your H arm. So this is called as magic T. And we have one more device, named as directional coupler. So for this directional coupler, so we have two ports on this side, port 1, port 2, and two more ports on the other side. So the main purpose of having directional coupler in a micro bench experiment is, whenever we are giving an input power, whenever we are giving an input power, this power is going to be traveled to this port. And if you want to measure the amount of power which is traveling toward this port, so we are taking a sample from this coupling port. That means the entire power, out of the entire power, we are going to take a sample from this particular port. So from this particular port, we can measure what is the power it is going to be transferred in this particular thing. Whenever there is a power coupling to this particular port, there is a possibility of reflected power towards this particular direction, towards this port number 4. In ideal cases, this port power should be equal to 0, but in real time, there is a possibility of getting a back power. So basically, if you look at this particular configuration, so this is called as input power port, and this one is your received power port, and this one is your forward coupling port, and this one is your back power port. Total 4 ports we are going to have in case of directional coupler. So, Magic T is also having total 4 ports, and directional coupler also is having total 4 ports, but the main application of using directional coupler is taking a sample from one port and measuring the power values. And the application of the Magic T can be used in multiple applications, like you can use a mixer, it can use as a duplexer. There are multiple applications of using a Magic T. In this particular lab session, so we are going to use E-plane T, we are going to use H-plane T, we are going to use directional coupler, and we are going to verify its S properties, S matrix properties. So next component is, we have circulator. Circulator, we can see here, these are rectangular waveguides, port number 1, port number 2, and port number 3. So it's a 3-port circulator. So this circulator also, we are going to use it in our microwave bench, and we are going to perform the properties of circulator in this particular playlist videos. And this is used for match terminator. Suppose we are giving power for this Magic T here, then we are going to measure power across any one of the other 3 ports. So in that case, we need to block the other ports by using the component called as matched terminator. So by connecting this, so we are going to connect the other ports, and we are going to have output from any one of the available ports of this particular Magic T. So this is very, very useful when we are going to deal, when we are going to implement an experiment with respect to E-plane, H-plane, or Magic T, or directional coupler, or any experiment, we are going to use this particular match load. So, the theory part and derivation part of E-plane T, H-plane T, directional coupler, Magic T, circulator, and match terminal. So we have created a playlist in this particular channel. So if you are interested, we have given a link in the description as well. So please go through the each and every video with respect to the theory part and its derivation part. This particular video, mainly we are focusing on experimental setup and the execution of the experiment and verifying the results of the experiment, that we are going to focus. Thank you.